You'll be hearing the word auspicious a lot during today's live. Auspicious color.
Auspiciousness.
又再次见你了，又是你。
Auspicious. Because we want. I mean, in English.
他做一个美好的、快乐的一年。
Yes, hi, my name is Sangwai and welcome to another episode of EM Live. Yes.
Yeah, I'm Piyu.
And I'm Manson and we're from Isa Music. Yes, so before we get to the program for the day, let's do a quick introduction of what Isa Music is about. So we're a Chinese instrumental shop and we primarily sell instruments. As you can see, we're surrounded by the lovely instruments. We teach using these instruments. Mm-hmm. We do repair for the instruments. We do rental and we do live performances as well.
That's right.
Yes. And every Friday, we'll be doing a live session on Facebook. Mm-hmm. And of course, today is different.
Today is not Friday.
Tuesday. And because Chinese New Year is coming, so we are doing a special episode today.
Yes. So today is the Chinese episode or Lunar New Year episode. Yeah.
But in usual cases, our Facebook Live will feature some topics that we usually would talk about. Mm-hmm. And we also share about, we share about the usual happenings, not the usual, the recent happenings in the Chinese orchestra scene. Mm-hmm. And we'll also introduce some of our new products.
Yes.
And also, sometimes we'll get a guest to come on board and to talk about stuff.
That's right.
And
that's
at
right.
the end of it, we usually would have a performance.
Yeah, so as we mentioned, so we're doing a Chinese New Year episode today. I mean, why are we doing this? Well, due to COVID, so there's a lot of restrictions. So we're thinking, why not we bring this auspiciousness, these festivities right to your household through our webcam today. Yeah, so when it comes to Chinese New Year, right, the impression is always about like loud joyfulness and Mandarin oranges, ang baos, lion dance and all these things. But little did we all know, right? Actually, Chinese New Year, there's a lot of Chinese instrumental music also. Like, just like Christmas songs can be very, like, yo-ya. Not just bing-bing-brang, dong-dong-chang, like, all these kind of things. So, that's why we want to take this opportunity to also bring to you the sounds and music of Lunar New Year as well.
Yes, and usually during Chinese New Year, during non-COVID season, we would usually have a lot of performances
everywhere.
In, shopping centers or in dinners or lunches for corporates.
Events, like just now I mentioned, live performances for events.
Yeah, so this year a lot of such dinners are cancelled.
Or not even happening, to be honest.
Yeah, and they don't want to do things to attract crowds. So, so this year is a bit quiet.
That's right. So to bring you better music, we have a special guest today, and this special guest will be joining us, and he's a good friend of Isa Music. He has appeared multiple times. He's the Deeds musician and conductor, Tong Wei Jie. Hello, Wei Jie.
Hi.
Hello.
又再次见你了，又是你。
你有那个中文脸，英文不好。Yeah,
but so we're gonna do primarily in Mandarin because we want. I mean, in English. Primarily in English. Sorry, folks. Because we want to share how we celebrate Lunar New Year here in Singapore to our overseas viewers as well.
Actually, the funny thing is we were supposed to wear Chinese costume. Then none of us remembered. And
No, I hung it. I did take out the costume and put it at my room door. So when I was leaving, I'll take it. But in the end, I mean, you...
Yeah, I did the same. It was there in the living room and I just took off. And
but it's okay, at least we wore red because red is a... auspicious color. So you'll be hearing the word auspicious a lot during today's live session.
We need a lot of auspiciousness.
I'm not sure if that's a word, but auspiciousness. it's auspiciousness.
Okay, what did I miss?
Yeah, and nothing much.
Okay.
Yes, so today we have with us is Wei Jie. So he's a theater musician and a conductor for various orchestras, for schools and for CC. And before we get on with the songs for today, let's just find out a bit about what you've been up to lately. Like any special recording just for Chinese New Year?
Yes, this year is very special because mm-hmm. the schools I teach have their Chinese New Year programs recorded to be played in school.
So we're not the only one doing it.
Yeah, I think many of us are doing the same thing.
We also have.
Which means this is the first year I won't be spending Chuxi with any of the schools, with my students. Yeah, because usually we will have a performance
or
in
like
school
for the celebration.
Yeah. Okay. So this year, none of that for me. I know there are some schools that still goes on with live performances, but
I'm not aware of. The most of them are doing recordings.
Most are recorded, So that's a challenge because mm-hmm. students tend to be very nervous when they record. So we may
have
to do multiple takes.
I think we all have
takes.
The same problem also.
Yeah.
So recording is more tedious than live, right?
Actually, true. Actually, because live, if you make any mistakes,
like
big
just now,
small, we will just go on with it.
Nobody will remember.
Yeah, nobody will remember.
Because it will be cut out.
Yeah, but recording, we want it to be perfect. Ma. And then those who participate, the performers also want it to be as good as possible. That's why.
So the next song, I mean the first song that we're going to play today is actually one of Wei Jie's favorite songs that I realize every time there's a gig with Wei Jie, this song will pop up. Yeah. So this song that we're going to play, right? Is it used in any of the recordings that you were?
Yes, actually, I did it with PCO.
Nah, last week. I sort of guessed this song will appear.
What's the first song?
Okay, so the first song is called Bu Bu Gao. It's a Cantonese tune. Actually, it's not really related to Lunar New Year, is it?
Yes, it's just an aspiration to.
Yeah, but
higher.
The title itself is very
auspicious. It's like something that you wish people, you know, when.
Gong Xi Fa Cai, Bu Bu Gao, Bu Bu Gao Sheng La, Bu Bu Gao Sheng. Yeah. So, before we start, let's explain a bit what's Bu Bu Gao. So, Bu Bu. Let's the Chinese major can can explain what Bu Bu Gao is while we put our mics.
Now I have to Bu Bu Gao meaning, I think everyone wants to be better in the new year, which makes Bu Bu Gao is a very relatable song to get like better and higher in whichever field we are pursuing in life as well.
So for those who do not understand Chinese Bu, that means a step.
Step at
so
a time.
So Bu Bu Gao, that means one step and another step higher, Gao is higher. Yeah, so...
You may mistake it for a kind of pastry. We have nian gao, fa gao, and we have bu bu gao.
Okay, so let's.
Let's play the song.
So, we'll be doing a series of Lunar New Year songs. So, thank you for watching, and this will be Eastern Music's and Wei Jie's first song for today, Bu Bu Gao. Please enjoy. Thank you. Alright, and that's Pupu Kao, a famous, I would say, a very staple Cantonese tune, other than Han Tian Lei.
Yes. I like this more than Han Tian Lei, to be
honest. It's a very joyful music, and I always look forward to playing this whenever we do gigs.
Yeah, I mean, I always look forward to listening to this. I haven't really played this. I mean, it's not very familiar with me.
So, good job! Okay, so let's start off a little topic about the songs of Chinese New Year. So, I'm not sure if you noticed that actually most of the gig Chinese New Year songs that we play right, actually have lyrics in them.
Yes.
Yeah, so like there's like 拜年, 恭喜, 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 发财, all this, right? And much like Christmas, right, there's always a recurring theme for Chinese New Year songs. And you want to make a guess? What do we always sing about in Chinese New Year song?
发财.
Yes. It's always about making money, getting a fortune. But of course, there's also
good
this...
health?
Yes, health, and there's this theme of reunion about the arrival of spring. Yeah, even though lately the 春节后 is always in winter. Yeah, it's because Chinese New Year, right, we follow a lunar calendar. Yeah, so unlike the Georgian calendar that we're using now, yeah, so sometimes the spring festival happens in January or even February like that. Yep. So it's like still around the winter like that. Yeah, it's not very... They can't really keep track of time. Yeah, so the next song that we're going to play, right, is called 恭喜恭喜. And it's this song like 恭喜恭喜恭喜你. Yeah. Yeah, so actually there's a... there's a very special backstory to it for this song. Did you know about it?
What is it? Is it a sad story?
I wouldn't say sad. Okay, it's from a sad story to what it came up today. Do you remember? You want to talk about?
I cannot remember. You want to share?
Yeah, okay.
It,
so
it started off with like celebrating Chinese New Year from what I read about. So it was about like end of World War II, was it?
It was, 恭喜恭喜 was actually written after the
war.
Sino-Japanese War.
Oh.
Yeah, so this song, right, it was... so if you read the lyrics, right, at the end, 不是 like 什么经过多少困难,经过多少磨练. Yeah. So actually, there's a bit of an interesting backstory to this. And the person who wrote this song is actually the person who wrote songs like 夜上海. Yeah, so it's written during that era also. So a little fun fact about 恭喜恭喜. So, I mean, don't think about it when you sing this song. I mean, there is... Yeah, but it's because of the lyrics. Because 恭喜恭喜, this word, right, is like literally means like congratulations. Yeah, so for us, when we celebrate Chinese New Year, when we meet someone, when we do house visiting, right, we'll say, oh, 恭喜发财, all this sort of thing. Like, it literally means, oh, congratulations on getting a big fortune. Yeah, so next song we're going to play to you is this very interesting backstory song, but it's also a very staple Lunar New Year song.
But anyway, this song is very different from... the rest of the song.
It's a bit of a minor.
It's in a minor key. It doesn't feel so joyous, you know. It feels a bit solemn.
I think once you slap the word 恭喜 on it, it's like, oh, Chinese New Year.
Doesn't matter how the song is.
So, yes, thank you for pointing out that. We do, sometimes when we play, it's like, oh, it's kind of minorish, you know, feeling. So, if this is your first time hearing the song, don't think too much about it. And enjoy this song called 恭喜恭喜.
恭喜 for listening to 恭喜恭喜.
恭喜.
Change the accompaniment a bit. make it not sound so sad. Yes. So we talk about the song mm-hmm. of Chinese New Year. So let's talk a little bit about what makes Chinese New Year song sound so Chinese New Year. Hmm. Yeah. So the next song that we're gonna play right is called mm-hmm. Si Yang Yang, and actually it features a very interesting instrument that unfortunately we're not playing it today. Uh-huh. So Si Yang Yang, right? There's this instrument that pops out. Do you know what instrument I'm talking about? I mean, there's a 笛子, like, but there is one string instrument that's like a very staple Si Yang Yang. That's right.
Oh.
Banhu. So yeah. So I want to ask the panel over here, our guest over here. Do you think it's the instrument that makes Chinese New Year song sound so Chinese New Year, or is because of how the song is written that makes it sound so Chinese New Year?
I think the 笛子 is what make.
Okay, okay, yeah. So we would relate like suona,
yes.
Luo, like drums, yes. These, all this that makes it really like the Chinese New Year, dong dong chang kind of sound. Yeah, but I think why Si Yang Yang is so special, and it's like when you hear it, it's like, oh, it's Chinese New Year. I think Banhu plays a part in it.
Banhu plays a part and 笛子 as well. I think Chinese music instruments, they all have a very Chinese characteristics. Okay, I'm correct. A very Chinese characteristic. Yes.
你要说中文吗? 很有中华特色
So as long as we use Chinese instruments to play Chinese New Year song, I think it would sound Chinese New Year. Of course, 笛子 like what I say is the most distinctive. Then of course if pipa also, and I mean 古筝 and 扬琴.
Yeah, actually 扬琴 not much.
扬琴 also, the one that's not much is 中阮, I think.
Ah, yeah.
Guitarish.
So would you, so before we start Si Yang Yang, do you want to try playing it on the banhu?
Oh.
Play what?
Challenge.
You mean? Do we have a banhu even?
Yeah, we do have a banhu. We have a banhu. Do you want to try it out or
try it
for the sake of our listeners? Okay, why not we take the banhu out and then you can just hear what how it sounds like.
Yeah,
I'll do that. I'll do that.
So why is it called the banhu?
Banhu because usually erhu is made of snake skin,
right?
But a banhu will be instead of the snake skin is a ban,
a
plank, a piece of wood.
That's why the sound, the tone quality is very different.
Yes, it's very high pitch, high pitch.
I'm not sure is it in tune or not.
Good luck.
Prepare your ears.
Is it trying to? Sometimes I wonder if instruments are trying to imitate voice or, you know, the other way around.
Like especially erhu, this kind of instrument.
Is in tune?
Oh. I'm not sure. Is it? Oh, so you're gonna try and call banhu? Wow. Okay. So, guys. So, folks, we actually rehearsed once. Before, yeah, like boss 10 minutes before we start. Yeah, and actually, boss was using a erhu to play this piece. So we're gonna attempt this using a banhu. Yeah.
Wow.
Very on, very hot, very hot.
Wow. Yeah. See, that's what I mean. This song 没有板胡, doesn't sound like.
Wow!
Yes, yes!
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, for an unrehearsed version of Si Yang Yang with Banhu, here's piece of music and continue.
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
恭喜恭喜恭喜恭喜。Yeah, why do we do this hand sign?
It's a greeting
gesture
back in the
day. Anyway, some fun fact about this song.
Yes.
This is actually my wedding's march in song.
Wow!
I cannot imagine that.
That's
so awesome. That's so awesome. So, you're the one playing the banhu when you walk in?
No. pipe in music.
Da Sao could accept it. She okay lah.
You were very cute leh.
So
were you happy that I suggested this song? Or you like?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, okay. Mm. So we talk about the wow, 果然是很 auspicious 的感觉. Okay, so we play. We talk about the music. We talk about the songs of Chinese New Year. Let's talk a little bit about the traditions and habits of 农历新年. So what do we do like? For me, it's always like 除夕夜, mm-hmm. I mean like the Chinese New Year Eve, 我们会有团圆饭, reunion dinner, mm-hmm. and then 就初一啊,有拜年, all this. So I just want to know like how you guys, because I'm Malaysian, mm-hmm. and we're in the majority Singaporean panel today. So how do you guys actually spend Chinese New Year?
I think for me, 初一 back in pre-COVID, right, we had this performance at like some of my friend's area.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So we do performance, then after that I go to my aunt's house and my closer relative house to actually 拜年. Then for the second day of
what is 拜年?
Like
拜
prayer.
Literally it means prayer, but 拜年 means like house visiting, house like visiting. That. Yeah. So keep that in mind, 拜年, you hear that a lot.
Then for second day I will go to my mother's my grandma house or my mother's
second day?
Yeah, on the second day.
初二.
They say it's 回娘家, so it's
okay.
You go back to your mother's house.
Mother's house. Oh, then how is reunion dinner like for you guys?
For me it's Neo Garden or every year.
It's
the buffet takeaway package kind of thing. We go in there and collect, and then we go to my grandmother's house.
Grandmother's house. Yeah. Because for us, right, we go to one designated person's house, and then it's really
everyone gets
fun G Tang, those kind of thing. It's so big, right? It's like we have a need to have a children table and adult. Do you guys do this kind of thing?
No, not so many people.
Oh yeah, we have a children table and an adult table. So it was from children table 一直坐到 adult table 的
But by the time children table 都会变成 adult 嘛, 全部
then,
adult
then
table.
Still have children table
还有
now. Yeah, everyone's married already. yeah. And then you guys know about like 拜太岁 this sort of thing or not?
Yes.
So there's this a lot of rituals and traditions for Chinese New Year. And I realized one thing, I do have some Singaporean relative, and I realized they like to do steamboat for reunion dinner. Is there a thing here? Because I realized a lot of households do steamboat in Singapore.
Yeah. We do steamboat on.
Is it a tradition
reunion
or is it
dinner?
Convenience?
It's like wei lu, you know, you like
everyone sit together.
Okay. Wei is
surround
the steamboat. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's also a very auspicious. It also has some meaning to it.
Yeah. So speaking of meaning, right? So 华人, 中华, like we use a lot of symbolism.
Yes.
Yeah. So for example, just now Xiaoban talk about wei lu, surrounding the stove. It's like sort of like a reunion, sort of 团圆的一种.
And if you realize Chinese, traditionally Chinese sit in
round tables.
So everyone can see one another.
But then mahjong is square, so cannot see each other.
Maximum four.
Scrabble.
Yeah. So I listed down some food that's like symbolically for Chinese New Year. Yeah, so maybe you guys can... I'll say a word and then maybe you guys can guess what it symbolizes and stuff like that. So the first one, right, is oranges or tangerines. What does it symbolize? Oh, suddenly become pop quiz, sorry. Yeah, so why? It's because tangerine, right, 橘子. So 橘, right, is a word that made up of the wood, 木, and then 吉. So 这个吉, right, 就是代表吉祥. So that's why Mandarin orange. That's why we always give Mandarin orange for Chinese New Year. Parrot, why?
成双成对, I guess. Like,
yeah, so 成, right, is also one of them because 成 sounds like 成功的成 also. Yeah, okay, so what about sweet rice cake, 年糕? What does it symbolize?
Bubu gao?
Yeah, actually, that, So it's a word play, 年糕. Oh. So 年糕.
Oh, yeah. 一年比一年糕.
Yeah, it's something like 步步高, that kind of thing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh my god. How can you guys not know this
because,
thing?
Because I don't eat 年糕.
Yeah, actually, I'm the, not a big fan of 年糕.
The looks of 年糕 isn't very
appetizing. Okay, so 年糕 is this brown chunk of sweet glutinous rice? Rice
sticky,
cake.
Yes.
So rice cake, yeah, yeah, 年糕. So why, how we do it, right? My grandmother actually makes, yeah, with omelette. Fried egg and 年糕. You guys have to try it. Eh. Oh. That's the only time I eat 年糕 when my grandmother make it with 煎蛋. Okay, so how about long noodles? I mean, this is very
长寿.
That's right. So 长寿面. So 长寿 means long
life,
longevity, long life. Wow, long big word lah, not bad. Okay, okay. I'm gonna spit this along. How about dumplings or like
dumplings?
Actually, I forgot what it means. Yes.
It's like
yeah, so dumplings is resemble like those small golden
ingots.
Ingots.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, 元宝. I'll put a picture on it when we are.
Yeah, it's what in olden China, their currency.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. Okay, how about okay pineapple tarts? It's more of a Malaysian Singapore kind of habit.
Onglai, right?
So what does onglai mean? Yeah, onglai, right?
Literally.
Yes, so actually it's prosperity arriving. Not everything is auspicious, okay? So onglai, so ong, right, is red in Hokkien. So it sounds like, oh, prosperity is coming.
Yeah, lai means come.
Lai. Okay, yeah, so last one. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if you guys ever heard of it, but, oh no, actually everyone heard of it. Yu sheng. Like lo hei. Yeah, why do we do that? So I'm not sure if our non-Singaporean or Malaysian friends ever seen this ritual we do during Chinese
it's
New Year.
An invention by one of the 四大天王 chefs in Singapore.
Oh!
It's an invention.
So what do we do for lo hei? Like, describe a little bit.
Each of the ingredients will be put in a big plate and auspicious words will be said. Tian tian mi mi, everything. And then everyone starts.
So, 每一个食物, 每一个材料都有一个象征啊. So, each food, each ingredient. So, it's like, yeah, there's the sweet citrusy thing one that means like tian tian mi mi. And then there's
黄金满地.
Yeah, so there's this cracker sort of thing. And then you sa. It's like, what is it called again? Like what's the term you use?
遍地黄金.
遍地黄金. Yeah, and then what about the fish? 年年有余. Yeah, all these things. Yeah, so if you
what's 年年有余? Maybe like explain.
Okay, 年年有余. So 余, right? Even though it's the fish word 余, but actually it's a word play also. The 余 means like abundance. Like you have left a lot of things. So 年年有余 means every year there's an abundance of something like prosperity, fortune, luck, all these things. So all these terms, right, if you say this during Chinese New Year, right, it's like level up. It's like, oh, thank you for the blessing. It's like, okay, like, Merry Christmas. Like, you mean during Christmas, right, you just say, oh, Merry Christmas and stuff like that. But Chinese New Year, we go all out when it comes to festivals. Oh, New Year, everything because we just love to hear something sweet in our life. And
auspicious.
Chinese
New Year. Start of the year.
Yeah, Chinese New Year is a good year for everyone. Some of the relatives, I only see them during Chinese New Year.
Oh, yes.
That's why 新年 is so important to like,
it's a very important occasion for everyone to.
Yeah, that's why there's 15 days. I mean, even in China, mainland China, right? The 他们是长假的嘛, 春节就是一个长假. So because they have to travel all the way back to their hometown just to visit.
To get tickets for them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's
this
right.
Year, everyone stays at home. Yeah, even the Lao Yu Shen part, Lo Hei, you cannot say auspicious. You cannot stay quiet and low.
You can play it from your phone. There's some app. Yeah. It gives all these things.
So just now I mentioned about tangerines, right? So I'm not sure why. 我是来了新加坡过后才发觉到的. When 拜年的时候, right, you guys give tangerines, and then when you guys leave, we don't do that in Malaysia.
有来有去.
Yeah. So like, is there a significance to it before we go to our next song?
I don't know.
I don't know, but
老人家这样做就
老板懂为什么吗？ 为什么拜年的时候要给橘子？
然后要回那个橘子也要回。
对， 为什么要回？
有来有去。
有来有往。
有来有往。
哦。 啊。
I think they cannot hear Lao Ban.
Okay, so just nice, our big boss is watching on the side. So we asked, like, why do we give tangerines in Singapore, actually? So when we do house visiting, we'll give tangerines. And then the house owner will return the tangerines, their own tangerines back to you. So it's like an exchange of blessings.
Well wishes.
Yeah, that's right. So Malaysians don't do that. So,
But actually, I heard a more cynical explanation. Like, if you don't take back the orange, you will leave your luck there.
Oh. Oh. Yeah, boss made it sound so much nicer. I mean, of course, Chinese New Year, oh no, we're a little bit, so Chinese New Year is also about gambling. Yeah, so there's a lot of these gestures that they want to be careful, like, or they want to leave their luck somewhere else because it's going to be bad for their poker hand later or something like that. Yeah. Okay, so that's actually a lot about Chinese New Year rituals. Mm. And let's go to our next song, and then we have one more song at the end. So the next song we're going to play to you is called Ying Chun Jie Fu. So it literally means welcoming the spring and taking the prosperity. Jie Fu. Okay, so before we start,
receiving the spring.
Yeah, receiving the blessings. All right, so this is Ying Chun Jie Fu. Chinese New Year, before we end the live session today, let's just go around and give our viewers some 祝贺语 for our viewers. So I'll start first because I'm very bad. I'm very bad with this sort of thing. So 我们要祝贺我们的观众今年2021年的时候呢，当然是最重要要身体健康了。So we wish that all of our viewers to have a very good health for this year and of course many years ahead. Yes.
And for me, I will wish everyone 岁岁平安，事事顺心. So meaning to say, wish that everyone would.
Suddenly cannot English.
Oh my god, how do I translate?
岁岁平安.
Uh,心想事成.
Yeah, so it's like all your wishes will come true, and your life will be 平安.
peaceful.
Peaceful. 平安. Yeah, 平安 is a new English word.
Ah, Ping An.
Yeah, great. Since they have spoken in English and Mandarin, I shall use Cantonese.
Hey, don't so cheat.
Yeah.
I'll translate for him.
Okay. 祝大家新年快乐，身体健康。 萬事順利，恭喜發財.
Okay, so he said that he wished that everyone would have a good year, and of course also good health. And also wish you to have good fortune.
Yes.
Oh, fortune 来了.
Okay, and
yeah, so of course I would wish everyone 身体健康. I mean, at this juncture,
yeah, we have to emphasize how important health is for 2021.
Yeah, and of course I'll be cliche and say 步步高升.
Ah,
Bubu Gao Sen means that everybody will be better each year. And before we play our next song,
last song.
Let us invite Da Lao Ban here to
wish
our viewers.
Yeah.
Yes. 老板，你要说几句话吗
？Okay, so this This is Mr. Tan, which is also my father.
So he will Baba-san.
Yeah, so he happened to be here, and can someone pass him a mic?
Why not your mic? Yep.
老闆站那邊啊,站中間。啊,在那邊啊。嗯。中間啊。Oh,
here comes 老闆.
Oh.
剛才這批年輕人組織了這一堂這樣的一個拜年的一個視頻,我覺得非常非常有創意了。這年輕人給我一個很大的一個感觸,我們現在年輕人對於我們華族傳統文化 这么重视，而且他们也非常很详细的讲谈到这个关于新年的一些非常细腻的一些东西，包括吃什么东西啦，又送红包啦，这方面的，我看连希望我们年轻人能够大部分青年年轻人，尤其是华族华人，能够更重视这样的一个新年的。 新年的传统的一个节日了，那么我非常高兴，刚才能够这么多年轻人，而且虽然他们是像我们新加坡双语啊，他们用英语的，能够表达出，也让更多受英文教育的人能够了解到传统文化、华族传统文化。那么当然，过去一年鼠年给大家带来非常大的灾难，那么希望勇猛的老牛能够带给我们 吉祥的曙光，那么在新的一年里，我代表公司跟我们其他的一些职员向大家拜个年，祝大家牛年吉祥，万事如意，身体健康，谢谢大家，希望在大家过一个美好的、快乐的一年，忘掉过去的灾难，谢谢大家。
There's so much to translate. I think let's not waste this energy.
Yes.
Yeah. So I'll leave the translation at the bottom of the screen once this video is re-uploaded on our YouTube and Instagram page. So to end off our live session today, let's do the last song, 新年歌儿大家唱. Let's sing a Chinese New Year song together. Thank you everyone for watching. 这是我们医生 Music 跟大家一起拜年的一个直播。嗯、so we also want to thank 伟杰老师、伟杰朋友，
客气了，客气了，
一起跟我们再次的出现在我们的直播。
谢谢，谢谢。
Thank you。所以也是要祝你今年会行大运。
哎呀，谢谢，太感谢了，太感谢了。
你有没有买东东呢？
我很想买，可是没有耐心排队。
哎呀，don't go and queue 啦，
不买是好的，对。
不买也是一个福哦。
不过我前一阵子中了大彩
哦，
彩票对，中了6块钱
哦，花了花了，
六六大顺，
六块钱也是钱哦，六六大顺呀。
我本来想去拿那个排队还有2个钟头，我只拿6块钱啊，我等过了年再。
Can you do the numerical 祝福？Yeah, so let's end off with a numerical 祝福.
Wow.
Yeah, so 一帆风顺，双
喜
临
门。对，然后三阳开泰，
四季平安，
四季
五福临门，六
六大
顺，
七星高照，
哇，三
面玲珑，
OK， 长长久久吧。当然，最后是要祝大家十全十美。So thank you for watching.And we'll see you again after our Chinese New Year break. Don't forget that we'll be closing from tomorrow.
No, from
the 11th. I want to have an early break, okay? So we'll be closing from the 11th of February all the way to the 16th of February. And we'll be open on 17th of February.
17th is next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday, that's right. So once again, I'm Anson.
I'm Piyu.
I'm Sanghua.
And we would like to thank our special guest for today, Wei Jie, for appearing on our live session.
谢谢你们请我来，要不然我今年没有没有 gig 啊，
没有时间
来
呀。
对，不是 break 完了，就 phase three 也没有
So don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on all our social media platform. And we'll see you again next time. Till then,
bye
bye. Thank you.